हाय प्रिंसी, गुड मॉर्निंग गाइस. कविता वर्मा, कोमल, प्रांशी, विग्नेश, गुड मॉर्निंग. हाउ आर यू डूइंग दिस मॉर्निंग गाइस? सो वी आर डूइंग 2019. गुड मॉर्निंग. आज करना है 2019 का पेपर. ओके गाइस, दिस इज 2019 स्लॉट वन. सो आर यू रेडी? यस. माय नेम इज हरप्रीत कौर ढोडी. आई हैव डन अ मास्टर्स इन इंग्लिश लिटरेचर, डिप्लोमा इन जर्नलिज्म. आई हैव अ लॉट ऑफ एक्सपीरियंस. आई हैव ट्रेन स्टूडेंट्स फॉर ऑल द एग्जाम्स दैट आर नेसेसरी फॉर द मैनेजमेंट एग्जाम्स गाइस. सो excited Pranshi, very good. This is my Telegram channel. All those who are not on my Telegram channel, please go ahead and enroll with Harpreet ma'am on Academy Cat right away. Yes guys, so you know we have two kinds of subscriptions. We have the Iconic and we have the Plus. Ask a doubt of feature. Any of the subscription, please use code 10 in order to subscribe. You will get a discount guys. Hashtag is there, crack management exams is there. Enroll now. There are many batches which started yesterday. Iconic means personal attention. So PYQs. I have been doing a lot of PYQs, guys. So I think all students need to do PYQs starting from 2017. You can lay your hands on not only CAT, guys. You should do even the ZAT papers, NMAT papers. Any of the past questions papers is very, very good learning for the benefit of students because there is so much that you can, it gives you an experience of the real examination and it is just the exam itself, right? So are we ready, guys? So we have 13 questions in one file and 13 questions in another file. So I'm going to start. Are you ready? So we will read passages, guys. Yeah, read this passage and we have to answer five questions on this passage. Five questions on this passage we have to answer. Done. In this particular test, right, 2019 slot one, this was the easiest passage, simplest and easiest passage. So it's talking about your connect with the topography. Topography is the land. Have you finished? So how you should map the passages, guys, let me tell you how to have a hold over the passage, how to control the passage. Now, first paragraph is talking about what is topophilia. Topo means land, philia, phil means love, right? So it may be the strongest of human emotions, so that definition, but when activated as passed to elevate a place to become the carrier of emotionally charged events to be perceived as a symbol. So topophilia being related to a symbol. Then the aesthetic appreciation is one way in which people respond. So aesthetic, beauty. Aesthetic is beauty, right? Then he is talking about, so this is all talking about that. Then we have the quite the opposite is second is topophilic bond, topophilic, namely that of an acquired taste. So this is aesthetic appreciation. First one, acquired taste is the second one. When a place is home, becomes the locus of memories. Third response is to the environment. Tactile, olfactory, smell, right? So it is a close conceptual twin. It is inspired by architects and planners. Urbanism is looking at it. So topophilia is difficult to design for and impossible to quantify. It is most articulate interpreters have self-reflective philosophers evoking a marvelously intricate sense of place, describing his affinity for the desert. Some people have this affinity for the desert itself. So do you have a complete hold over the passage, guys? Now, last paragraph, it's a positive relationship. Dark affiliation between people and places. Patriotism literally meaning the love of one's terra land and homeland. Now, this sentence is talking about residents of upscale residential places and how they respond. And then this last sentence is talking about the phobia. Okay, so map the paragraph, understand, divide it into different sections, understand ki what is each paragraph talking about so that when you go to the questions, you know where to look for the answer, right? So if I'm talking about the three concepts, they are in the second paragraph. If it is talking about topophobia, it's in the last sentence. One reading should give me a control over the passage and I should know where to look for answers. So I go back only to refer, not to reread. Try to reduce the time that you read. Read only once, read actively the first time. When you go back to the passage, you only go back to refer, not to reread. Fine, guys? Have you finished? Do you want to read once more or is it fine? Okay, let me go to the questions. First question. Now, where is topophobia mentioned? Where should I take you? Last sentence. Yes. So read this sentence and just as, so you just go back to refer. Landscape is revealed, so too many landscape of a fear cast a dark shadow over a place that makes one feel a dread of anxiety or topophobia. So what is the answer, guys? I will do the poll. Very good. Aparna, Anshi, Chahat, Shreya, Aman. Very easy question. A question you should get it correct. Can't be easier. It is more like a question you will come across in school. Right, guys? And still there are many people. who are marking the wrong answer. Almost 26% are marking the wrong answer. Yes, so guys, learn to be judicious in the choice of answers. Topophobia, land and fear, representing fear towards places and spaces. It cannot be towards topophilic people. Is he saying it's a fear of topophilic people here? I took you to the passage. I showed you the last sentence. Is he saying it's a fear towards topophilic people? Not at all. Is he saying it's a metaphor expressing the failure of the homeland to accommodate non-citizens? Kaha mention hai. Where is he saying that the homeland has a fear? Right, guys? No excuses for getting wrong answers. Please focus. Get the correct answer. Let us go to the second question. Yesterday was 2018. Yeah, no, yesterday was just a mixed bag of questions, Komal. Yeah, we did only para jumbles. There were no passages, right? It was just a sectional test. Yeah, I thought you were asking about YouTube. Yeah, second one, guys, what is the answer? RC. So not contradicting. Yes, correct, Aparna. Let me take you to the passage. Answer is C. Now, look at this. This is the most important, most fundamental response to environmental is tactile, olfactory. Is he saying it is the most important response? It is the third most important factor, not the most important. Third most important factor, right? Second one can be ruled out because the author says in the first paragraph, emotive ties with material environment vary greatly from person to person and in intensity mode of expression. He says they vary greatly. This is saying very little. Do you see this? I'm reading from the sentence, guys. The emotive ties with material environment vary greatly. Now, if you look at this one, this can be seen in the last paragraph is parallel to what the author is trying to say. It's not contradictory. What is he saying in the last paragraph? It is not contradicting. What is he saying in this third? Patriotism is a positive feeling presented by the author in the as a darker form of topophilia. What is he saying in the last paragraph? Patriotism, literally meaning love, has been cultivated by governing elites for a range of nationalistic, including war preparation, ethnic cleansing. Yeah. Reinforcing class and racial differences. Yes. Also, yeah. So that is why that one is parallel, because he's talking about it is disclosed as an important to maintain distinct identity. You didn't understand the question. Yes, understanding the question is very important. So what is not contradicting? Two negatives will make a positive, right? Not is negative, contradicting is negative, becomes a positive. So this is parallel. Do you understand, guys? New Amazonism succeeded and architects collaborated with their clients is also mentioned, no? New urbanism seeks to counter the perceived placelessness of modern suburbs. Okay? Got it? I'm going to go slow so that you absorb every question and understand it. What is he saying about residents of upscale? This one is easy, guys. Jo bade gharon mein rehte hain, why do they choose to live in big houses? Upscale residential areas. Why do we choose to live in an apartment which is worth 15 crores? Why would you spend 15 crores to live in an apartment, guys? Generally, that's not what the author is saying, but generally speaking. Why do you buy a Louis Vuitton bag for 1.5 lakh rupees? Why? Good. Nenu baga unnanu. Yes, guys, answer is B. Yes, social exclusivism practiced by residents is in order to enforce a sense of racial and class superiority. You want to set yourself apart. That's what the author is saying in the last one. Status, correct. 1 minute, let me explain, show you this. Have disclosed how important to maintain distinct identity by casting themselves in a superior social position by reinforcing class and social differences. I want to set myself apart from people who are not rich. Right, sensitive response to race and class problem. No, no. Where is he saying it is a sensitive response? What is the need? What is the feeling of the residents of upscale residential apartments? They don't want to merge with people who are not rich. Not that it is a response to race and class problems. Class superiority. Okay, Jignesh? Yes, coming to the fourth one, guys. Question number 4. Get all of them correct. Shreya, very good. Yes, 83% getting it correct. I am very happy with that. Impressed, guys, mightily impressed. Very good. So answer is A, right? Because each one's response is different and he's giving you the example of who is this person who loves the desert. So somebody likes the desert, somebody likes mountains. So he's saying that Henry David Thoreau, evoking a marvelously intricate sense of place as Walden Pond and Tuan, describing his deep affinity for the desert. So subjectiveness is what the author is trying to say. Subjective is what you feel is your own emotions, right? That is why it is difficult to quantify. And again, it is a very data-based question. Do you want me to take you to the passage where he's saying topophilia is difficult to design for impossible. Most articulate have self-reflective philosophers, affinity for the desert. Now you understand, guys? Okay, now let us go to the next question. I want you to get all answers correct. Question number 5. Which of the following comes closest in meaning to the author's understanding? So this is known as what you will call as parallel reasoning. So what is parallel to what the author is saying in the paragraph? This may not be mentioned in the passage, but what is the sentiment which is closest to the sentiment that the author is talking about in the passage when he's describing topophilia? Yes, understand the questions, guys. Yes, answer is this one. Tendency of many cultures to fatherland, motherland be as an expression. So you have this connect with the land. You feel that it is your own, what you will call as a relative of yours. So this is what you are going to, in fact, infer from the passage. So it is a love for a particular place. And this is reflective of love, right? This is not the answer because it is talking about the least affinity of the land and nomadic societies. Societies which are on the move cannot have an attachment to any land. French are not patriotic, is going against topophilia, which will bring about patriotism. And topography has nothing to do with topophilia. This is a different idea. Therefore, the answer is A. Can you see how I'm eliminating options, guys? You see how I'm eliminating. You have to do this whenever you do RC. Just like I'm explaining to you, you have to explain to yourself. You have to do this elimination. This word is incorrect. This word is incorrect. Then on the day of the examination, you will be very fast. How many of you have got 5 on 5? What is your score on 5? I think the second question was tough. Second question, you should have got 4 at least. I'll show you the leaderboard in the next question, Jignesh. Okay, now let's go to the next one. Guys, please go ahead and take the combat. This is a mega combat. Those who are attending my classes are sure to get a good score. Yes, so remember ki you have to use Core 10 to unlock Mega Combat on Sunday. This time 250, first 250 students, 250 students who are getting a rank will be getting a scholarship. Is that okay? Yes, please go and take the offer. 12 months ke liye, 3 months free, 24 months ke liye bhi 3 months free. Use Core 10, you will get a 10% discount. Taint means to mar. Yes, to cause any kind of blur. Genteel, refined. Yes, any other words, guys? very refined sofas. Nowadays, on the sofas, you are getting all these floral prints, which are all relating to folk literature. Done, guys. Parochial. Now, parochial means narrow-minded. So, Aparna, around the church, the people who lived around the church was called the parish. And people who lived around the church were very conservative people. So parochial or leading to parish or parishioners means very narrow-minded traditional people. So that's why it's going with conservative. Yes, done. Sudden whiff means just a small wind, like a, what can I say? A whiff of fresh air, if I say. Yes. Sudden burst of something is known as whiff. Rendition is his narration of something. Done. Thronged means to crowd or collect. Heavy passage, right? Yes, is the passage heavy? Lot of words. Ballet is used to be any kind of a play which was carried out in the form of song, in the form of songs. Pura play was in the form of songs is known as a ballet. Storyline bhi hota hai usme. Doesn't matter, we can still arrive at correct answers. Always, when the passage is very tough, the questions will be easy. Pastiche is fashionable emulation and pastiche. Emulation means copy. And pastiche is any kind of a musical or literary piece. Done, guys. So all of them are causes for plurality and diversity between within the British folk, except. So can I go to the passage to show you where he's talking about diversity? So diversity, the author is trying to tell you, comes from past influences. Sorry. Yes, informative. There is no lag, Shreya. So it's telling you has achieved a rare distinction just as the floral prints, and yet a newspaper column, a whiff of, now look at this, containing elements of uncanny eerie as well as antique veneer, a whiff of Britain's heathen dark days, the very obscurity, anonymity of space. So the whole paragraph is talking about basically that the fact that it was very, very different and very diverse. Right? Yeah. Now, so we have to first understand the question. So which of the following are causes for plurality and diversity within the folk tradition, except which is the one which is not the answer? So diversity comes from long history of past influences, right? So that is why we can, option one supports that and two also supports that. So can I do the poll? Let me see if you are able to mark the answer, guys. Answer is A. This is not mentioned. Diversity can be, sorry, I misled you, I think. Paradoxically, forms are both popular and unpopular is not mentioned. British folk continues to have traces of pagan influence from the Dark Ages. They can be traced to remote past of the country, owing to history, moral ode of transmission. He's telling you, you know, a moral ode, like one telling the story to the other. So this is the one which is not mentioned. Both popular and unpopular is not mentioned. Okay, let us go to the seventh one. Which of the following statements about folk revivalism of the 1940s cannot be inferred from the passage? Now, where is folk revivalism of the 1940s and 60s mentioned? Here. For the second wave of folk revivalists, starting in the 1940s, the vital spark was communism's dream of a post-revolutionary journalism. For the younger successors who thronged the folk clubs, set up the old guard, the lyrical freedom of Dylan and the unchained melodies of psychedelic created the conditions of folk, is what he's trying to say. Now try to find the answer, guys. Let's find the answer for this one, seventh one. Yes, Shreya. Shreya, Jignesh, Pranshi, Navya. I see a lot of people leaving because the passage is very heavy. Right, guys? So we have two more questions and then we will go to other type of questions. Let me show you the leaderboard. Shreya is 7/7. Very good. Jignesh is 6. Harendra Pratap 4. Navya, Komal, Piyush, Pranchi, Aparna, Manthan and Anshi. Yes, guys. So here, it could not have happened without the influence of rock music. That's why he's saying psychedelic lights. Melody was created by the conditions of folklore. Can you see this? So that is why the answer is B. Now, may often appear a cosy fossilified form. 8th one, what will be the answer? Piyush. Yes, so something which is always going to be cozy and fossilized will always refer to the past, guys. And the only option is D. It's not talking about political, cultural or antique veneer. Antique is ancient. Debates and disagreements, it's talking about the past. So that's the clue you have to pick there. Primary purpose of the reference to William Morris and floral prints. Why is he referring to the floral prints on sofas, guys? Yes, Jignesh. Again, a tough question. No, answer is C, because the author is trying to prove that what was once considered as radical folk can be seen as conformist today. We are willing to accept it today, rather than a persuasive influence of folk on contemporary art, culture and fashion. So answer is C. He is saying C, which is really actually not very convincing. Last question in this passage, guys. Least likely to agree. Yes, Shreya, Jignesh, Pranchi, Anshi. Sakshi. Yes, folk lit forms and their ability to constantly adapt to changing exhibit an unusual poise. Homogeneity. Homogeneity means similarity. On the other hand, he is talking about heterogeneity, which is diverse. And poise means a certain kind of dignity, which the passage is not talking about. Right, guys? So this is the odd man out. Yeah, these are all mentioned. This is the one which is not mentioned. Okay, are you getting answers correct? You want to do a passage or you want to do other questions, guys? Should I do this passage, continue with the passage? Okay. No, Kavita is saying no, Shreya is saying yes. Jignesh is saying no. What is the vote, majority vote? Okay, let us do two questions, then we will come back to this passage. Yeah, let us do this one. Can you do the para jumble? I'll do the poll, guys. 30 seconds. Yeah, very misleading, unconventional opening. B is the opening sentence, an example of cognitive distinct. Just because it says example, you're not looking at it as an opening, but it's introducing the idea or capacity to think of ourselves and others have beliefs, desires, thoughts and feelings. B is followed by now you're on the right track. Sorry. Yeah, correct, correct. Correct, Piyush. Yes, all of you have the answer. It is B, C, D, A. Now, mind reading looks increasingly like literacy. Print reading, like mind reading, goes across cultures. People with dyslexia have difficulty in reading. Okay, let us go to the next one. This one is very tricky, guys. I don't want to do this. There are two options there. Yeah. Okay, can we do this passage? We have exactly 15 minutes. Very interesting one. Interesting passage, very true of what is happening in today's life. You should get all the answers correct on this one because it's very easy. Done? Okay. Interesting, right? Yeah, we all deal with this on a daily basis. Okay. हाँ किया था YouTube पे. Done. We have to answer 5 questions on this. Done. Why is the author giving you so many examples here? Last sentence. Last paragraph said this, guys. Yes, Shreya, Anshi. Jignesh. So there is one more test on Monday. Monday 11:30, guys. One more sectional test coming up. So they may transform into what they were exceptions to. That's what this paragraph is telling you, isn't it? Casper, so he's telling you most of these companies are based on hundreds of millions of dollars of venture capitalists. And they cannot achieve this by selling one mattress or a sneaker. They have expanded into bedroom furniture. Glossier, after selling makeup, is asking you to skill to apply makeup, glittering color cosmetics. There's no way to out of the buying into the right thing. So what they were not doing today earlier, they are doing now. Yeah. So they started off as a promise of simplicity. But then they have ended up with doing things which they did not do earlier. That's why it is B. Question number 12, guys. Yeah, parallel reasoning question. Piyush. Jignesh. Yes, he's talking about something which is not high. It's a mid-size price. That's why we will look at 10 products for $5 to $10, right? Because he's also trying to recommend that highly functional option with mid-range prices. So this will be the best one. 13th one, all the following except. All the following can be, which is the one which is not mentioned? Yes, Manthan. Aparna, Baishali, Pranchi. Yes. So this is the one which is not mentioned. The fact that they prefer to buy products from startups and over those from established companies is not suggested. He is talking about made it difficult for consumers to trust products, too many products, diversity, susceptible to marketing images that they see on social media. All this is mentioned. This is not mentioned. 14th one, understand the question. Critical reasoning question. Yes, guys. So B is actually telling you what the author is also saying. Right from the start, he's in favor of offering limited choices to customers. And he's also trying to say that offering fewer products can bring positive results. So the second one is not weakening. The others are all weakening. Hi, isme time chahiye tha. Correct. Actually, वो 30 seconds का लगा हुआ है and I'm continuing with that. Okay, guys, let us do 15th one. I'll give you 1 minute. Yes, answer is C, which is the one which is least depth to the author's prediction. So answer is C, exponential surge in sales enables startups to meet their, to meet their desired profit goals without expanding their product catalog. This is the one which would add least depth. This is all adding depth. That means this is supporting. Supporting. Yeah, this one also. This is the one which is not supporting. Right, guys? So that was the last question for the morning. Can we stop here? So again, we have one on the Monday, 11:30 a.m. I will see you with a sectional test. Right, guys? Okay, so all the best. Have a great day. Bye-bye. Questions are very tricky, Komal. This is one of those questions which is very tricky, adding least depth and except questions, which are the ones which are weakening, which is the one which is not weakening. It's not even asking you direct CR questions, but indirect CR questions, which is making it a bit complicated. Okay, guys, see you on Monday. All the best. Take care. Bye-bye.